look for a better day. Amen. For a lot of people, these are tough times.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. Times of uncertainty. Mm-hmm. Amen. Probably got a lot of people.
Yes.
Times of financial concerns.
All right.
Health issues. Amen. There are worries on the job.
Yes, it is.
Worries in our homes. Worries at school.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
And then let's talk right now of higher taxes.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Yes,
amen.
Yeah.
Less help. Amen. Less benefits. Amen. And some of y'all know about the benefits. Amen. Less benefits. Amen. And then every time we look up, there's corruption in high places. We don't know who to trust anymore. Ain't that right?
Yeah.
Amen. And then all of these things got us nervous.
All
right. Amen. Mama's nervous.
Yeah.
Grandpa is nervous.
All right.
The children is nervous. Babysitter's nervous. Handyman is nervous. The dog is even nervous. Don't nobody know what way things are going to go.
Right.
Amen? Amen. And when we look at this scripture, it seems real strange that a man in prison is telling the church to rejoice. Amen. Paul was locked up. And yet he sent word to us that we should rejoice in the Lord always. And just so we'd get the message, he said, and again I say,
rejoice.
Let your gentleness be. Amen. When we start looking around us, we wonder, how can Paul, being locked up, be writing to us, telling us to rejoice, trying to give us some hope? Amen. But see, Paul knew something. Paul knew that whatever happened to him, whatever he had to go through, that the Lord was with him.
Amen.
Amen. He knew that his destiny was set, that God had already made a way for him.
Amen.
And he just was have to deal with these things that we got to go through.
Amen.
Hey, wouldn't it be wonderful if you knew that the trouble that you have in would last always?
Amen.
Amen. If you knew that the sun would don't come up in the morning. Amen. Some of us don't know that. We look around because we think darkness is even in the daytime.
Yeah.
Stuff in our life is dark. But Paul was telling us that what is inside of us don't have to reflect our outward circumstances.
Amen.
Amen. You need to be looking for a better day.
Yeah.
Amen. Because if we get caught up looking at what's going on in our life now, it'll make you start drinking.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. And if drinking might take too long, that'll make you start doing something else.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. We start supporting other folks' problems.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Y'all hear me?
Right.
Amen. Because we be buying that stuff that they got a problem and they trying to save us.
Yes.
Y'all don't hear me. Y'all hear
yes.
me. Mm-hmm. Amen. If you got something that ain't no good, you want to get rid of.
Yes.
Right.
And then we convince ourselves that it's good for us because of our situation that we are in.
Amen.
And all that does is make our situation worse.
Yes. Right. Yes.
Amen, because if you do wrong, sooner or later, wrong going to catch up.
Yes, yes, it will.
Y'all don't believe that,
amen.
So
yes.
Sooner or later, it's going to happen.
Yes.
It may not happen the way the world says it's going to happen, but it will happen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You know, a lot of what we go through is not the result of nothing we learned later.
Uh-huh.
Y'all hear me? The decisions we made years ago in some cases.
Yes.
But they always come back to get you some kind.
Yes.
So Paul says that your inner self even though these are tough times, and even though we're going through things that we never went through before, and even though we're not certain about what's going to happen tomorrow, the inside of us ought to be full of joy. Because, see, joy don't come from our circumstances. Joy only comes from the Lord. Amen. We ought to have joy. If we got God inside of us, we ought to feel pretty good. We ought to be able to rejoice. Because I know God's going to come see about me. Amen. I told y'all the story of the two people that were marooned on a deserted island, and the plane went down, and they were sitting down. There was one old boy, he was trying to build a fire. He was looking for wood, trying to build a fire so somebody could come rescue him. The other guy, he was over there laying up under a tree. Didn't have a care in the world. One guy told him, "Man, you need to come help me so they can find us." Old God said, "I make $100,000 a week." He said, "They ain't gonna help you out here on this island." He said, "And I tithe. My pastor gonna find me." Amen. We gotta have some confidence that whatever we're going through, that God knows. And God's gonna see us through. Amen. So we can be thankful today. Yeah, you may not have a bigger turkey as you wanna have. You might even have to work on Thanksgiving Day. But God knows where you are. Some of us may not even have employment and wondering about whether they're going to cut off whatever we're getting and whatever we got. But let me tell you, God knows the situation you're in. Paul said, because of the situation you're in, you ought to rejoice. You ought to be praising God with confidence that God knows your situation. And you know God. Amen. If you know God and God knows you, God ain't going to leave you in that situation forever. Amen. Sometimes it's just a matter of the way we think. Ain't that right? Paul was on to talk about things, didn't he? He said, now, look at the scripture, what he said. He said, you need to be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. Amen. Prayer opens up the door for conversation with God. Amen. And if you know where you are, then you can just pray with some confidence that God's gonna see about you. But let me tell you, if you pray and nothing happens, it ain't because God don't know you pray. Maybe you're out of the ark of safety. Yeah. Maybe that you got yourself in a situation where God's prayers can't get through. You know, sometimes we get so hung up in the world that we can't hear nothing.
Amen.
Y'all didn't hear that, did you?
All right.
Sometimes we get hung up on our problems, on our situation, that we don't know God is just standing right there. All you got to do is stretch out your hand and put your hand in Him and trust Him, and He'll see you through. Now, I never told you that getting out of trouble is going to be easy, doesn't it? Amen. We got to go through some things. That man sung a song a long time ago about a woman. He said, the same thing it took to get her, going to take the same thing to keep her. Y'all don't remember that song. That's an old song. Well, the same thing that got you in trouble is going to take a while to get you out of trouble. God is able, but you can't keep doing what you've been doing and hope to change your situation.
All right, now, come on.
Amen. You need to start looking at things different. And Paul talks about that a little later on when he gets to that eighth verse. He says, whatever things are lovely, Paul says you need to have a little control over what you allow to go into your mind.
All right.
Paul said, there's another scripture. He said, so a man thinks him, so he is. If a man thinks he's in trouble, you know who he is? He's in trouble. If you think that your situation is hopeless, well, it is hopeless. So you need to start looking up. You need to start looking for a better day. Ain't that right? And if you're looking at the day the way you always looked at the day, the better day ain't coming. Let me tell you, sometimes in the middle of our despair, God sends us an anchor. But we in such a mental state that we don't see the anchor. Ain't that right?
Right.
Amen. You know, and we're looking for a job. We're looking for a job, but we got such a narrow focus on the job that we don't see that a job is waiting on us.
All right.
It just ain't where you think it or where you want it to be. But you know, I found out a long time ago, when you get a job, it's easy to get a job. That don't make sense to y'all, do you? If you're unemployed, don't nobody want to hire you.
All right.
Because they wonder why it is that you ain't got no job. But if you get a job, I don't care what the job is, if you get a job, then you can get a job.
Yeah.
Amen. Because folks look at you funny when you ain't worked, especially if you ain't worked for a while.
Mm-hmm.
Longer you stay unemployed, the longer you're going to be unemployed.
Amen.
Y'all hear me? Yeah. Then a lot of times we get jobs and we underemployed, and so we don't give that job our best effort.
All right.
Well, if you don't do good where you are, you're not going to get no better. So it's a mind thing. We got to start looking at life differently from the way we used to look at it. If we're looking for a better day, then we need to start looking in a better way, don't we?
Yeah.
We need to start trusting God. We need to believe that God knows and God cares about our state.
Yeah.
Some of you may say, well, God couldn't care because I've been struggling for a long time. Ain't that right? God has promised you that he will come to see about you.
Amen.
Amen. Job went through a whole lot of stuff, ain't that right?
Yeah.
Years and years of struggle.
Yeah.
But God did come to see about him. Job didn't turn around. So our faithfulness will help us get where we need to be.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now you got to have some kind of plan, don't you? You need to know where you... You know, a lot of folks, I just want more. I want better. What are you willing to do to get whatever you need? You can't look for a better day, amen, unless you're willing to do something.
That's right.
All of us gotta put something in if we want to get something out. Ain't that right? Amen. And the Paul says the first thing he put in, he gave up himself.
Amen.
Amen. You can't hold on to you and give yourself to God too.
All right.
Amen. And some got to give, don't it? You can't still be the master of your own self and let God be the master too. So you got to turn over something. Start with you. The only thing you got is
you.
Rest of you got you. It ain't making you. Ain't giving you no joy. Ain't giving you no peace. Ain't that right? And let me tell you, the world's joy is different from the spiritual joy. Because the world's joy make you depend on how things are going. Having good feelings. Being in a good place. But God's joy comes to you regardless of your physical circumstances. God can make you feel good about yourself, even if self ain't got nothing going on. Amen. Because you know, we put too much emphasis on things that are really unimportant. Yeah, y'all didn't hear that, did you? We put too much emphasis on things that are really unimportant. When we don't have the stuff we think we need, we all down and out.
Amen.
Everybody got it but me. Ain't that right? But you still alive. And you ain't did nothing to stay alive. Amen. You've been abused everything that you've had. Amen. But God is still waking you up every day. And half the time you don't want to wake up. You put so much stuff in you to sleep.
All right. I'm telling you. Yes.
Y'all didn't hear that, did you? But God still woke you up.
Yes.
And he'll abuse your own mind. Amen. But God still loves you.
Amen.
And you have an opportunity. I just think of all the people that are struggling with life today.
Uh-huh. Yes.
And rather than going to the